that I have been internet dating. Thank you. That's about the reaction it generally gets. You know, in the first show, half people were like, what? The inner what? You know, but I'm with you guys. It's not the coolest thing, you know? I mean, I gotta be honest, when it's like 3 o'clock in the morning and you're sitting in your fake cop uniform in West New York typing your internet dating page, you know, it's not the high, that's when you realize your life did not work out the way you expected it to. You know, and then you write this great essay and then like you wanna be really charming and funny and you get to the bottom of the essay and you're like, do I write or best offer? Right, that's implied. Everybody knows you're gonna settle, just like real life. And one problem I can't get across, and I've been on internet dating forever, so I should know. I mean, when I started, it was just a CB radio, you know? And every date was at a truck stop. I was an early adopter on the internet dating thing. And so I can't get across the fact that I'm being sarcastic. That's my only tool in the dating toolbox. I don't know, it's a bad metaphor. And so I'm talking to this woman, she's like, we're trying to decide what we're gonna do on our big first date. And she emails me, she's like, you know what I've always wanted to do? I've always wanted to go apple picking. Right, although that's working on some people in here. You know, we are at a national park. And so then I write back at the speed of the internet, I'm like, yeah, that's exactly what I wanna do. And that's how I hear it in my head. She reads it, she's like, I have met the most romantic man on the face of the internet. Why does this guy need the internet to fall in love? He is love. You know, he defines love. You know, doves are flying by her house, dropping my name in rose petals. You know, and then I got to live up to that. So 2 days later, we're in the friggin' apple orchard. How many apples do you need? You get there in the first 10 minutes, I had like 90 pounds of apples in the burlap bag. I'm dragging the apples through the orchard. Right, it's like I'm making applesauce is what I was doing. And you know, I've got to be manly because it's a first date. She's like, you want me to help you with that? I'm like, no, I got this. Oh, don't worry. They ought to just put an empty barrel by the gate where you drive in for the next schmuck who's on his first date. You know, you can just dump your apple. How many pies can you bake, you know? And she's like, you sure I can help you? I'm like, no, but I got like 400 pecs in here. You know, I don't even know what the pec system is anymore, but I'm not well versed. 400 pecs of apples is more than I can carry. I'm going crab apple picking on my next date. I want nothing that doesn't fit in her purse. That's perfect. How we doing? I got four in here and a cherry tomato. Let's get out of here. All right. And somebody told me, you gotta compare yourself to a celebrity. So I described myself as looking a lot like Michael Phelps. And, thank you, lady, for laughing at me on that. And, I'm with you. I think because I do that whole 10,000 calorie a day diet thing he does on the weekends. I just don't do any of the swimming to burn the sausage off. And that is the key to making that diet work. You can't go out and get the slaughterhouse special where you're like, I'll take the egg, sausage, bacon, and ham, you know, without swimming for 10 miles. And so one thing I do like about internet dating is that you can pick people by body type. You know, I'm sure women, you know, look at, you know, under statuesque, you know, and I'm there with a couple other guys, and I like curvy women. I like women who, you know, who look like real women. I think I need a new hand motion for this, because this makes me look like I like snowman women, you know? I need something hip. I just love a hot snowman girl. The coal eyes, the carrot nose, the way she melts and goes away every March. It's perfect. I can play golf and fish until November and get another girlfriend when it snows. It's perfect. She makes a mess, I clean it up with a towel. It's perfect. And so I'm talking to the curvy girl, and I forgot that while I'm lying about how I look, because here's the thing, when you're internet dating, you're not lying, you're picturing yourself on your very best day ever. Because I can picture, it was like summer of 94, I was at the beach in Delaware, and I was really lean because I'd had diarrhea all week. And you know, that is when you get your friends to take all the pictures they have memory for. Like, get a lot of shots of this because the gut is coming back by the time this weekend is over. I'm going to eat my weight in crab cakes between now and Sunday night. You know? And my friend's like, dude, you look good. What are you dieting? You're working out? I'm like, yeah, I'm working out. I'm eating the right diet, only expired foods. That's it. I cannot keep an ounce on. That's perfect. And I'm picturing is, you know, me at my best, and I forget everybody else does that. Because I'm talking to the curvy girl. We decide to meet for a drink, and for a second, I'm thinking, I hope she doesn't think I really look like Michael Phelps. But then I see her walk in and I realize that's okay because she's not so much curvy as she is round, actually. It was a curve. It was one 360 degree curve. What the hell? Curvy means more than one curve. That's why it's pronounced curvy and not curve. Right. You see curve, you know what you're getting yourself into. And you know what she looked like? She looked like Violet Beauregard in Willy Wonka when she got... All right.